Well, I want to thank you for coming to listen to the Word of God today as we come and we think about the Word of God in these difficult times in which we live. Unfortunately, we cannot meet as a local church, but we thank God for these opportunities that we have just to share His Word. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we want to rejoice and be glad in it. So wherever you are, whatever you're facing just now, we're glad that you're able to join us, and we pray that God will bless us individually and collectively. Let's just pray together and ask for God's help and blessing. Our Father, today we thank you for this new Lord's Day morning that you've given to us. We thank you for all your blessings in life. We thank you for the week that has gone out into eternity. We thank you, Lord, for protecting us, for providing for us, for watching over us, and we thank you for the grace and the mercy and the love that you have showered upon us in abundance over the week that is gone. But today is a new day, our Father, and we long that you might draw near to us and that you might bless us at the point of our great need. For all who listen today through your word, we pray that you would lift them far above their circumstances and that they might know sweet fellowship with the living God. We realize there are many who can't be here today. They can't share with us in any form. Father, we just ask your blessing upon them as well. And we pray today especially for those who are anxious about loved ones, for those who are closed in their own homes. We pray for those today, our Father, in the hospital ward who are seeking to give of their best, their time and their talents to help others at this difficult time. Would you protect them? Would you provide for them? Would you help their families through these days? And may the rich blessing of God be upon each one of them. We pray, Father, for all our elderly members and friends, and ask your blessing upon those who no longer get out to meetings, who are perhaps in their own homes or today in residential care. We just ask, Father, for your blessing to be upon each one of them. So, Father, as we come to you just now on this another new morning, we ask for your help and for your blessing, and for the short time we spend around your word, we ask simply that you would touch our hearts and that you would encourage them. We pray in our Saviour's precious name. Amen. Amen. It's a joy today to have the opportunity again just to come to the Word of God and to encourage your heart in what is a difficult time for so many of us. And I want to read to you the verses of Psalm number 91. And I want you to listen just as the Word of God is read. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, and Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder. The young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. Because He hath set His love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble, I will deliver him and honour him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Amen, and God will bless the reading of his word. I said to you last week that in the midst of all the circumstances that we are facing at this time, it is so important that we maintain our focus on the things that really matter. And because of that, it is so important that we focus our thoughts upon the Word of God, because through the Word of God, we can find strength and help, we can find comfort and consolation. And therefore, we need to be listening to God's voice today amidst all the other voices that are crying out to us amidst the chaos and the confusion. We began a little series last week that I call Some Encouragements for Such a Time as This. And when we turned our thoughts to Psalm 46, we looked at an encouragement for the faint-hearted. You and I know today from that psalm that we can be encouraged by God's protection. God's people can have a steadfast confidence as they journey through life, so long as that confidence is deeply rooted in God and not in ourselves. Because after all, the psalm says God is our refuge and strength, a present help in trouble. And we can be encouraged by God's power. The psalmist's confidence was in a God not only who was ever present, but a God who was one powerful God, sovereign over all of creation. And because of that, God says, be still and know that I am God. Be encouraged by God's presence. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. So whatever we face in life, even though heaven is his abode, and even though he rules over the whole earth, God is deeply interested in you and me individually. So we need to focus on him, and we need to focus on his word. And today in Psalm 91 that I've read to you, we come to another beautiful psalm where we see an encouragement for the worried saint. I know that as Christians we are not told to worry and we shouldn't worry, but in the days in which we live, with all its uncertainty, there are many people who are anxious about so many things. Some people are anxious about the coronavirus. The deaths are increasing, and they're praying that this virus doesn't visit their home. Some people are anxious about family members who are working in the hospital under great duress and putting their own lives at risk in order to try to save the lives of others. Some people are anxious about their jobs. They wonder, whenever this virus has run its course, will there be a job for them to return to? And some people are just anxious about the future. Everything around them causes them deep concern, and as a result of that, they don't know how to cope in days of great uncertainty. And that's why I turn your thoughts today here to Psalm 91. This is a psalm that is one of a favourite psalms, I'm sure, for so many people. And I can understand that, because many of the saints of God have had their faith strengthened by the great statements of faith we find in this psalm. And it is so much to say to your heart and mind today, but I want to mention just two simple things. One commentator says this about Psalm 91. In this psalm, we get a glimpse of faith at its very best when things were at their very worst. So what are the two things that I want you to think about in this psalm today? Well, first of all, I want you to see the dangers that the psalmist faced. You cannot read throughout this psalm and not feel that if the psalmist is not in some kind of immediate danger now, that he has passed through dangerous times in the past, and out of the depth of his own experience, he assures us that God preserves and God protects those who are his children. Two things about that. You will see here the psalmist's experience. If you look carefully at the psalm, you'll note in verses 3, verse 5, 10, and also in verses 11 and 12, some of the dangers that the psalmist had to face. And he uses some very descriptive terms relating to dangers that were very real and very personal held to him at a particular time in his life. We can see that his enemies were standing against him, his enemies were setting traps for him so that he might fall. And so much so that he found himself in a very vulnerable position. It seemed as if his life was under threat day and night. And on top of that, he had to live through times of famine, and he had to sleep through nights of danger. And all in all, for him and for the people generally, things were very difficult. The hearts of the people were melting with fear, and they were living in days when it was so easy for them to lose sight of God. I think that's one of the great dangers that is facing us in our world just now. We live in days that are difficult, where so many things are happening that we don't understand, people affected whom we know, and we desperately need to stay focused on God. Beloved, if we do not keep our eyes focused on God in these changing days, if we don't trust him, there's every possibility our steps could falter and our faith could crumble and our situation could make us so over anxious that we feel that there is no hope in pressing on. Unfortunately, some people may have already done that. They've got their eyes of God, they're walking not by faith but by sight. They're looking at things from a human point of view. They're trying to use human wisdom to understand things that are way beyond our understanding. And they're looking for answers when perhaps there are no easy answers forthcoming. But you and I must, at times like that there, look away from these things and recognize that God's ways are not our ways, that his thoughts are far above our thoughts. And when we don't understand our circumstances, we must trust God in the midst of them. When we feel anxious, we must not allow our feelings to misguide us. And when we feel overwhelmed by the events of life, we must look to a sovereign God and exercise our faith in him. If we don't, and the moment we look away from him and get our eyes off him, our hearts will tremble, our faith will weaken, and our anxiety will take over. So we see the psalmist's experience, but secondly, we see the psalmist's escape. Look at verse 1. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You see, in the midst of the darkness and despair that the psalmist faced, he wasn't overwhelmed because he knew that he had a hiding place. He had a place of great security. He had a place of protection. He had an avenue of escape from all that was going on around him. And that place was in God himself. And that's why in the midst of life's journeys, when the storms of life would seek to overwhelm us, we need to hide in God. Because in him, we enjoy a place of great security. We receive strength for the journey. We experience a life without fear. We can enjoy a life of victory and peace no matter the difficulties and the dangers that we face. Beloved, I'm encouraging you today to keep your eyes heavenward, to rest quietly in God and to be absolutely certain in your heart that he is in control and that you can trust him irrespective of what is happening in our world just now. But if you are over anxious today and you're worrying about something and it has consumed your heart with fear, listen to the words of the hymn writer. When the storms of life are raging, tempests wild on sea and land, I will seek a place of refuge in the shadow of God's hand. Why there? Because he will hide me, safely hide me, where no harm can e'er betide me. He will hide me, safely hide me, in the shadow of his hand. Beloved, there's no better place to be today. When we're trusting in God and hiding in him, we are in the safest place in the whole world. And there's no chance that fears will overwhelm us or that our circumstances will cripple our faith. When we're hiding in God, we're safe from all of life's alarms. So we see here the dangers that he faced. But secondly, I want you to note the declaration that the psalmist makes. The writer here reminds us that God preserves and he protects all those who trust in him. And you and I can take great confidence in that. You might say to me today, but how do we know that? How can I be sure that these things are true? How can I be confident that God will not let me down at that particular time of need in my life? Well, let me say three things about that. Firstly, we can be sure about that because God never fails his people. He never abandons his people. He has promised in his word, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. And secondly, the lessons we're going to learn from the psalmist here would remind us that God will not and he cannot fail his own. And thirdly, we can be sure if we look back on our own experience of life, all the way my Saviour leads me, what have I to ask beside? Can I doubt his tender mercy, who through life has been my guide? God has not failed us before, and he's not going to fail us now. But look at the psalmist's personal experience for a moment, and there are two things recorded for us that might be of help to us. First of all, you can see the psalmist's confidence. He says this in verse 2 of this psalm. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. These words, of course, are figurative and they are descriptive, but they're also encouraging. God is my refuge and my fortress. These words further emphasize what we had thought about last week in Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a present help in trouble. And those words need to be written on our hearts in these uncertain times. There are none of us who know what a day might bring forth. But God is right now, with all that is going on in our lives, a refuge for his people. He's the one in whom we hide until the storms have passed us by. He's the one in whom we can hope when it seems that all hope is gone, and he's the one in whom we find our strength when it seems that we have nothing more to give. Beloved, in God today we find a refuge for every storm, grace for every trial, strength when we feel too weary to go on. God is not only a refuge, he is a stronghold for his people. Charles Spurgeon, the Prince of Preachers, uses these words when he says this, we must fly to the Lord for shelter, and not to the arm of flesh. The bird flies away to the thicket, and the fox hastens to its hole, and every creature find its refuge in the hour of danger. In all perils let us flee unto Jehovah, the eternal protector of his own. And that's what the psalmist did. And that's why the psalmist was able to say, my God, in whom I trust. John Bach was one of three missionaries who went to Greenland to bring the gospel to the Eskimos. For a period of time, as he worked with the people, he had to face great cruelty and criticism. The people tore down the missionary huts, they broke the furniture, they destroyed the missionary boat, and they even tried to starve the missionaries to death. And day by day, things got worse until their lives were under threat. But in the midst of the danger, even with his own life under threat, John Bach remained faithful to his call and he trusted in his God. One day, a group of Eskimos stormed into his home. They threatened to kill him there and then, but with confidence he remained steadfast and began to witness to them the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. And sharing the love of God with them that very day, God began a work amongst these people. I'm sure under the circumstances that many others, including me, might have given up, But even under the threat of death, John Back found his refuge in God. Whatever child of God you're facing today, you must do the same. Find your refuge in God, because God remains a refuge for his people. We see his confidence, and secondly, we see his protection. Verse 4 says, he shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. These words, wings and feathers, of course, are figurative language. They just speak to us about the tender and loving character of God's protection. I want to tell you a little story that bears out what I'm trying to say to you today. On one occasion, a forest fire broke out in one of the large forest parks in America. And when the fire broke out, it was so intense that the flames engulfed everything in its path. Once the fires had gone out and it was safe to go into the parks again, some of the park rangers went out to see if any of the animals had survived. As they went from place to place, they found nothing alive. And just as they were about to leave the area, one of the men saw the remains of a bird that had been burned in the fire. He kicked the charred remains of the bird, and as the bird moved, out walked four little chicks that had been protected under the wings of their mother. Do you see, beloved, you remember this, that whenever danger comes, we have the protection of God. Because God conceals us and he protects us, and we're hidden in the hollow of his hand. He even gives his angels charge over us to keep us in all our ways. So I would encourage you today to take this lovely psalm to heart. Draw great confidence from it. When we trust in God and when by faith we rest in him, we are in the safest place of all, the safest place on this planet Earth. And because of that, we can start looking up and we can be free from anxiety. And we can live life with our confidence in God. And then you and I too will get to the place where we're able to say, like the psalmist said, my God, in him I will trust. Whatever the days ahead bring into your life, no matter how your heart or home are affected by the events of our world, I encourage you to read this psalm again and again. Because here in Psalm 91, we have an encouragement for the worried saint. May God bless his word to us and help us on our journey through life. Let's just pray together. Our Father, we thank you for the preciousness of your word. We thank you for all the lessons that we can learn as we journey through life. We want to thank you, Father, that you're always with us, that you protect your people, that we are safe and secure in the hollow of your hand. Father, there are many people in our day and generation who are over anxious about so many things. We pray that you would just bring peace to their troubled hearts and minds and to their homes. Maybe some listening to my voice today, and they need, our Father, that you would draw especially near to them. We pray that you would do that. Bring peace to a troubled soul. Give grace for days to come. And help us, our Father, all of us today, just to rest confidently in our God. We commend ourselves to you, all who need our prayers today. We commend to your tender and loving care, and ask for God's richest blessing to be our portion and the portion of God's people everywhere. And we ask it all in our Saviour's worthy and precious name. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for joining with us today. God willing, I will keep you up to date on Facebook, what we're doing throughout this week. Tomorrow morning, of course, on our Facebook page, you'll be able to read something for the journey. And again, that's just a short devotional message that would help us just to journey onward this week that lies ahead. Please feel free to share any of our videos or to share something for the journey with others that they might be encouraged in these days of uncertainty. So please take care, stay safe, and may you know God's blessing upon you in coming days. Amen. Amen.